kidding, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy. Don't know why you're here.
Well, thank you. You may be seated. Before we actually begin the ceremony, I would like to start up by asking a few quick questions. Please raise up your hand if you speak Spanish.
Un poquito.
Uno. One and a half. Okay. How about English?
Whoa.
Okay, the rest of you. Very well. So today's ceremony will be in Spanish. Okay. Now, turn to your neighbor, either to your left or to your right, and at the count of three, you're gonna say, I'm so happy to be here. Ready? Una, dos, tres.
So happy to be here.
I told you it was gonna be in Spanish. Well, on behalf of Jim and Jane, we'd like to welcome and thank each and every single one of you for coming all the way down here and having to suffer under these beautiful weather conditions, and maybe later on with a piña colada or margarita. We want to thank you for being here. So, bienvenidos a Puerto Vallarta. Ooh. Muchas gracias por estar aquí. Welcome to Puerto Vallarta, and thank you for being here. Now, I would like to read a short portion from the scriptures. It's the Gospel according to John. It's chapter 15, verses 12 and 13. It says the following. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. Again, please turn to your neighbor, and again at the count of three, you're going to say, love is to give. Una. Dos, tres.
Love is to give.
Oh. Now, these words were spoken by the Lord Jesus Christ a few moments before the passage of the cross. Now, I personally believe that they enclose the essence of what true love means. It starts off by Jesus saying, love each other as I have loved you. Now, what is it that Jesus did that made the difference? Well, he was someone that led us not only through his beautiful words, but he also led us with his example. And that's how he wants you to love each other, as an example of giving. Now, he was willing to love us all the way until that very moment in which he, hanging on the cross, says, it is done. And that's his example for us. Love each other with everything you have. Hold absolutely nothing back. Your dreams, your heart's desires, put everything into this that says, I love you. Then he goes on and says, there is no greater love than to lay down your life for your friend. Now, who is a friend and what is a friend? Well, a friend is somebody whom we like to hang out with. We share jokes. We have a great time with that person. But then on top of that, we have another kind of friend that when we're feeling a little bit low, they might just enter in the room in which we're in and then make us smile. But then on top of that, there is another kind of person, another kind of friend that when you're thinking about him or her, you're going, you know what? I cannot imagine spending the rest of my life without the company of that person. I want to share the rest of my life with that person. And then you suddenly go, wait a minute, that's my spouse. And this is what we are celebrating this wonderful afternoon. We're saying, I am laying down my life for my spouse. I am laying down my life for my friend. And there is no greater love than this. Now let me quickly give you Bible 101, okay? Let's imagine the Garden of Eden, okay? And there is Adam in the middle of the garden, who probably looked very much like Jim, but without so many clothes. Okay? So God looks at Adam and says, it's not good for man to be alone. So he makes him fall asleep. And although the Bible doesn't actually mention it, I personally believe that God took the rib closest to Adam's heart and from there formed someone as beautiful as Jane, but she was Eve. And so when Adam finally woke up, again, the Bible doesn't mention it, but I'm sure he went, wow. And then he goes, now this is flesh of my flesh and bone of my bones. So it was God that performed the first wedding ceremony here on this earth. Now, if we go to the end of the Bible, the book of Revelation, we have another wedding ceremony. It's Jesus getting married to his bride, the church. And so that's how important marriage is for God. Because it is his design for us to be able to experience love at its greatest dimension. It is his design for us to be able to say, I want to lay down my life for my special friend. I want to lay down my life for my spouse. And that's the essence, and that's what the secret of love is. To take the decision to give your life, to give your love, to give your heart to that special person. That is why love is to give. Now let me give you some practical advice on how to do this. Jim, we'll start first with you. Okay? Now, in some cultures, I don't know if in North Dakota they have this or not, but in Mexico they say that the man is the king of the house. Do they say that in North Dakota? Well, let me tell you, Jane, she is your crown. And without a crown, there is no king. And the place of the crown is always on top of the head of the king. Okay? So it's not so much the nice house, the nice car, the nice clothes, although all that really helps a lot. But it's letting them know that every heartbeat of you is an I love you. It's letting her know that she has such a special place in your life. And when she realizes this, then she'll say, yes, my king. Okay? Now, Jane, this is for you. You look wonderful this afternoon. Doesn't she?
Yes.
Woo!
But really, what made Jim fall in love with you is the Jane from inside. And really what gets him going and his heart pumping is your smile. So if you want to make Jim a happy husband after he's been stuck in the freeway in 6 feet of snow after a blizzard and the heater's not working in the house, if you really want to make him happy, welcome him with a smile. You know what? You can start practicing right now. You can smile for each other. Please smile. There we go. Now, this is for both of you. I know we have to be kind, compassionate, loving, forgiving, etc., etc., etc. But above all, you have to learn to be of one mind. Now, what do I mean by being of one mind? It's not that you have the same opinion about things, or you like the same food, or you even color coordinate to go out for dinner at night. It's not about that. It's about learning to plan your lives together. Just as you've planned this wonderful afternoon here before God and before our witnesses in Puerto Vallarta, you have to see yourselves. Where are you going to be maybe 2 days from today, or 2 weeks, or 2 years, or 5, or 15, or 20 years from today? You have to see yourselves growing old together. Picture yourselves holding hands on a beautiful beach, walking off into a wonderful sunset. Because today, you have been awarded the greatest privilege that any human being can experience here on this earth. And that is a privilege of loving and being loved. The privilege of saying, I want to lay down my life for my friend. Remember, love is to be. Okay? Now let me tell you a little bit about the rings. Now, here we have the rings, round, a symbol of love. That means they have no beginning and no end. The rings are also a symbol of authority, because Jim, with this ring, you're giving your name, okay. But if there's anything I'd like you to remember this afternoon, it's the following. I don't know if once your mom or dad or your grandparents ever tied a little knot around your finger. But this is what the ring is. It's a reminder of your commitment before God and before the witnesses to lay down your lives for one another. And when you go through the difficult days, and you know they're difficult days, the days in which you really don't want to lay down your life for your friends, you know there will be some days.
Please remember to look at the ring on your finger and say, I decide to give. I lay down my life for my special friend. Okay?
So, Jane, can I have the phone? Let me give you a ring.
Now we're going to say the wedding vows, so please hold hands. Now, Jim, repeat after me in a loud voice. I, Jim Schultz.
I, Jim Schultz.
Promise to love, honor, and protect Jane.
Promise to love, honor, and protect Jane.
In richness and in poverty.
In richness and in poverty.
In health and in sickness.
In health and in sickness.
In good and in bad times.
In good and in bad times.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Now do you, Jim, take Jane as your wife before God?
I do.
Very well. Please place the ring on her finger. Now, Jane, it's your turn. Ready? Okay. I, Jane Karen Smith.
I, Jane Karen Smith.
Promise to love, honor, and respect Jim.
Promise to love, honor, and respect Jim.
In richness and in poverty.
In richness and in poverty.
In health and in sickness.
In health and in sickness.
In good and in bad times.
In good and in bad times.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Jane, do you take Jim as your husband before God?
I do.
Very well, please place the ring on his finger. Now, I would like to talk to you a little bit about the sand ceremony. Here we have two vessels, and they contain sand. Now, when God created mankind, basically, he created them from the dust, in other words, sand. And if we look at these grains of sand, they all look alike, but nonetheless, each grain is quite unique and different. And that's how he made us. We all look alike, but nonetheless, each one of us is quite unique and different. These two vessels represent you as individuals, where you come from, your traditions, your backgrounds, the way in which you think. But now, you will be pouring the contents into this third vessel. Please go ahead. Now, here we have a new blend, and it's virtually quite impossible to separate it. And as the scriptures have stated, what God has united, Let no one separate. Now I'd like to say a prayer for this wonderful couple. And I'd like to ask them to please be so kind to stand up. Please stand up. And let's extend one arm forward towards them. Let us close our eyes. Heavenly Father, Holy Spirit, and Lord Jesus, I place before you the lives of Jim and Jane. You know their dreams, you know their hopes and their heart's desires. Today is a dream come true, but this is just one of many, many more dreams to come true upon them. I declare that as from today, they begin to experience love in a new dimension, your dimension. A love that gives and shares and lays itself down for one another. But also I declare that this love, not only may they share it amongst themselves, but they also, with this love, touch their families and their friends and the people around them. But above all, I declare that this love touches future generations. That they're an example to everybody else, a beacon of light. When people look at them and wonder and ask and say, what is it that makes them always have a smile for one another? What is it that makes them always be the difference? That people might come to the understanding and say, Jim and Jane truly knew the meaning of love. They understand that love is to lay down their lives for their friends. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Son. And I thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. Now the groom may kiss the bride, and you are now husband and wife. Okay, give me your flowers. Well, we have some special words from Jim and Jane. Okay.
I, Jim, do promise you, Jane, my love for as long as I live. What I possess in this world, I give to you. I will keep you and hold you, comfort and tend you, protect you and shelter you for all the days of my life. As our families are joined, we shall go down the highway of life as one.
Jim, from the first time I met you, I fell in love with your beautiful brown eyes. The night we met, I didn't give you my phone number, simply saying I was in the book. However you thought my name was fake, you found it. I'm glad you called me. I can't believe that has been 10 years ago. You have brought out the adventurous side of me from all of our many trips to Mexico, our motorcycle trips, and most of all, building a house together. Through all this, you have showed me nothing but your love for me. Today, as we formally pledge our love and commitment to each other, I not only get to be your wife, I get to be a second mom to your three beautiful children and a grandma to those five wonderful grandchildren. From this day forward, I promise to love you and cherish you all the days of my life.
Bravo.
Well, you can kiss again, why not? Ahora sí que se oiga música, maestro. Okay, let's hear it. Bravo!